السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. The aromatherapy. What's aromatherapy? It is a scientific practice using pure essential oils to bring about body equilibrium and improve mental and physical health state. It involves more than the use of fragrance, as essential oils have therapeutic activity according to composition of each oil have variable biological activity. Essential oils are also have antiseptic activity variable from each oil to the other. Why we use aromatherapy? Aromatherapy has effective results in reducing stress, improving sleep disorder, also effective in treatment annoyed skin and preventing complaint of itchy dry skin, eliminating the complaint of stomach pains and GIT disturbance. The word aromatherapy comes from aroma meaning odor, therapy meaning treatment or to treat. So the definition of aromatherapy can be the art and science of utilizing naturally excreted aromatic essences from plants to balance, harmonize and promote health of body and mind and spirit. Aromatherapy, applying the concept of healing with aromatic substance. The main component in aromatherapy is essential oil, which have the effect when applying with massage. So the essential oil and movement or pressing to certain points of the body. Aromatherapy is a caring hands-on therapy, which aims to induce relaxation, increasing energy, reduce effect of stress, and restore the lost balance to mind, body, and soul. The controlled use of essential oils to maintain and promote physical, psychological, and spiritual well-being. The controlled use based on knowledge, based on science of these oils. Aromatherapy in history. It's used back to 6,000 years as the ancient Egyptians extracted the oil from aromatic plants, used them as an incense in religious ceremony and in their temples. Egyptians also use aromatic fragrance as a massage after bathing, and these aromatic principles were used in embalming as a preservative. Then comes the Greek, use also these aromatic principle and apply the use in medicine and in cosmetics. Dioscorides wrote a book about herbal medicine with listed of many essential oil and their application in medicine and treatment. Then come the Romans, take their knowledge from the Greek and improve their ability of using aromatics in medicine, with additional principle came from India and Arabia. Ibn Sina, who was the first to use the distillation of volatile oil, who distilled essence of rose. During this period, Arab also distilled alcohol around the same time, making it possible to produce perfume with alcohol without the need to heavy oil base. This is an instrument for distillation of oil and alcohol at this time, known as al-imbiq. The origin of aromatherapy came also by chance from the word French word aromatherapy, which coined by the French chemist René Gattefossé. René, his family has a perfumery business. He was working one day in their lab where his hand burned. Directly, he plunged his hand in a container containing lavender oil, and he was amazed about the calming and analgesic effect of lavender oil and the healing activity of this oil. This motivated him to search about the use of lavender oil and uses or application of other oils for the medicinal benefits. There are many ways for application of volatile oil, as in candles, vaporizers, and in. So what are the essential oils? Essential oils, widely distributed in the plant kingdom, sometimes referred to as a plant's life of force, or plant's essence, or plant soul. When dealing with essential oil, there are some safety measures should be taken. Essential oil is highly concentrated substance or mixture of substances, so should be diluted with suitable carrier oil, usually almond or sweet almond oil, jojoba or sesame oil used as carrier oil before application to skin to prevent skin irritation. If skin irritation occur, addition of lavender oil or addition of more carrier oil is done. When applying essential oil, it's better to apply them as a mist spray. Care must be taken when using essential oil with pregnant women, as many oil, either essential oil or the carrier oil, can stimulate uterine contraction. Parsley, basil, bay leaves oil, marjoram, safflower oil, all can stimulate uterine contraction. Small amounts of some oils reported to be safe during pregnancy, such as bergamot oil, coriander, cypress, and frankincense oil. With nursing women, they should be careful when using essential oil, as the oil can pass to the infant with its effect. Highly allergic person, simple test can be done to determine the sensitivity to the oil or the component of the oil and carrier oil mixture. Why we use essential oils? The therapeutic grade oils are so effective in helping to cure as well as preventing diseases. Essential oils have small molecule size so that they can quickly penetrate tissues of skin. Essential oils are fast acting when applied to palm of feet, palm of hand, and they can reach circulating the blood within 20 minutes or less. Due to their volatility and high evaporation rate, they don't accumulate in body. Because of their chemical structure, they are metabolized in cells like other nutrients. Essential oils are lipid soluble, and they are capable of penetrating cell membrane even if a membrane is hardened or inflamed. Essential oils can affect every cell of the body within 5 minutes, then metabolize like other nutrients. Essential oils, according to the University of Vienna, can stimulate blood flow, which increase oxygen and nutrient delivery. The essential oils are of the most powerful known antioxidant. They have strong antioxidant activity. Sister being constituent of essential oil, have the ability to cross blood-brain barrier, carrying oxygen directly to the brain. Some examples of essential oil and their particular use in aromatherapy. The Angelica oil from Angelica Archangelica, the oil obtained from the roots and seeds, containing pinene, felandrine, limonene, linalool, and borneol. Its use include relief of migraine, relief of nervous strain, and for bronchitis, cough, and colds. Bergamot, or citrus bergamia oil, the oil obtained by cold expression of the fruit peel, it shouldn't be applied to the skin. If it will be exposed to sunlight, the oil of bergamot shouldn't be applied to skin if it will be exposed to sunlight, as the oil is phototoxic. It's used aromatically for stress-related condition, mainly as antidepressant activity. Also, it have antiseptic activity to the skin. combined with eucalyptus oil and the carrier oil, bergamot oil used to relieve symptoms of cold sores and suppress irritation of chicken pox. Borneol, Triobalanobis aromatica, also known as liquid camphor. It has long history of use, containing wide range of terpenes and sesquiterpene constituents, and alcohol and resin. It has been used to relieve stress-related disorder. Cedarwood oil, from different plants, to belong to family Pinaceae, one of the first reported extract to be used medicinally, used by the Egyptian in as perfume and in embalming purpose. It has also widely used in traditional medicine, used aromatically for relief of nervous stress, effective insect repellent. The chamomile, wide range of uses, especially in aromatherapy for relief of headaches and insomnia, obtained from Morocco or Menses multicalis, and from German chamomile matricaria, and from Roman chamomile. It has calming and soothing activity, useful anxiolytic, help in curing and relieving insomnia, effective as a massage in treatment of dry skin. Clove oil, used for tooth pain and valuable antiseptic activity, used in aromatherapist for digestive complaints and antispasmodic purpose. Eucalyptus oil, usually it's topically applied, but it's non-toxic, can be taken internally, can't be taken internally, as it could have fatal activity. Characteristic aromas used in soap, perfume, and cosmetic preparation as a relaxant in aromatherapy. Vapors of eucalyptus oil, effective in clearing nasal passage during symptoms of common cold and congestion from catarrh and sinusitis. The effects of essential oil. The effects of essential oil can be due to topical application, penetration through skin to bloodstream, with effect on digestive system, respiratory, causing detoxification of the systems, affecting hormonal system, cardiovascular system, muscle and joints, and affecting lymphatic symptoms. Or through olfaction and inhalation by olfactory nerve to the olfactory bulb, neocortex to the thalamus, activating limbic system, hypothalamus through pituitary gland to adrenal glands, thyroid, reproductive glands, and digestive hormones activity. So the effects of volatile oil can be through penetration through skin or through olfaction with effect on thalamus, hypothalamus to the pituitary and its mastering glands, or the effect through the internal or systemic use of volatile oil. Ways of using essential oil. Topical application of essential oils. Usually the need referring to the concentrated or undiluted volatile oil. Many oils are safe to apply directly to skin. Lavender is very safe even to children without any dilution, but care must be taken as some person have sensitivity to different constituents of essential oils, and when using lavender oil, it should be written as lavender oil, not lavandine or genetically modified lavender, as it may change the composition of the volatile oil, so will change the effects of the oil. Using essential oils usually is done with application of carrier oil. The carrier oils are vegetable mixing oil, extend the effect of the essential oil, providing more efficient use when applying in massage. The vegetable oils helps in lubricating skin. Some excellent carrier oils including cold pressed grape seed oil, wheat germ oil, sweet almond oil, sesame oil, or a blend of one or more of these oils. Another way of application of volatile oil is through inhalation. Direct or indirect inhalation. The direct inhalation by placing few drops, two or more drops of the oil in the palm of the hand. Then rubbing both palms clockwise, the flat palm of hands, then cup the hands together near to the nose so as to inhale the evaporated oil. It is by collecting the rubbed hands near to the nose so to inhale the evaporated oil. Or inhalation through the volatile oil bottle directly from the bottle, or by adding some of the oil to the hot water and evaporating or inhaling the released oil with the steam. Present diffused oil alters the structure of the molecules, creating the odor rather than just masking them. It's changed the structure of the molecules responsible for the bad odor existing in the room. In this way, it can destroy the odors of molds, cigarettes, animal smells, not only masking them, then after evaporation of the oil, the bad odor will be permanent. Diffused oils also increase oxygen availability, producing negative ions and releasing natural ozone. Many oils such as lemongrass, orange, grapefruit, eucalyptus globulus, tea tree oil, lavender, have long use in eliminating and destroying airborne germs and bacteria. Oils taken internally or central use of volatile oil. All essential oils are generally regarded as safe or certified as food additive by FDA. They are safely taken internally as dietary supplement or as component for treatment of certain complaints, but ingestion of oils should be done under direction of health professional. Oils also so strong tastings to put them into capsule and swallow them. They are combined with hard gelatin or with pills formulation. But this is with therapeutically described or therapeutically prepared grade of volatile oil, not to each type of volatile oil. The source, composition, and way of preparation of this oil should be carefully known. And thank you.